If you're new to Elm, you will sometimes see a function with the type HTML message. And that kind of is confusing. What does that mean? It's a two-part type. And if you're not familiar with sort of the metaphors of Elm, it's going to look a little weird. So I wanted to go over what that is with you so that you would be less confused and understand what's going on here. So what that actually means is it is an HTML type that is then parameterized over the message. Okay, let me go into that in more detail because that probably is a bunch of words that doesn't actually help you very much. So HTML is an opaque type. It is how Elm code instructs the virtual DOM how to render your page. So you may have a function in like div that creates a div, or text that creates a text element in your HTML. But of course we want our HTML and our application to be interactive. So the user, if you have a div, the user might want to click on that div, or if it's a, as if it's a button. In that case, the HTML will generate a message that will be fed back into the Elm event loop to be processed later. So what HTML message means is we have an HTML element that can produce messages of that type. So normally message is a union type. It doesn't have to be. You could have a HTML that reduces messages of type integer, for example. I'm not sure why you'd want to. Normally you wrap that in a union type of some form. But you might have different places in your application where you have different things generating events of different kinds. So, for example, maybe you have a calculator in your thing. You can, you know, for a function calculator, you can do that. So you might have a type called calculator messages, which would include, you know, data input for when people type in numbers, or, you know, add, subtract, multiply, divide. And those types would be parameter. The HTML that generates your calculator would generate those types of messages. Whereas another block of HTML in your code might generate different types of messages because it's doing different things. So the nice thing about this is it prevents cross-contamination. The messages over here that generate calculator events are different from the messages over there, which generate other events. And your type system, that HTML message, keeps this clear for us. So you don't have to ask, well, what happens if this HTML generates that kind of event? Answer, it doesn't. It can't. Type system, if you tried, the type system would simply say, hold on, your types are wrong. And then your compile would fail and you'd fix it and then your code would work. So it's a way of what HTML message fundamentally does is constrain the HTML to only produce one type of messages to exclusion of all others. And that way you can understand that that HTML only produces these messages, whereas this other HTML may only produce these messages. It's all about the constraints and the guarantees in Elm. It's a sort of a running theme here. And HTML message is a wonderfully powerful tool. You have to understand that what it really means is that the message part is a way of telling HTML only create this kind of event. And if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my channel or share it on Facebook or Twitter.